Hi, this is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and on this overcast afternoon, I am going to be slugging pear slugs. Yes, I'm in my killer mode, because last night when I was looking at my beautiful purple leaf smoke bush, what did I find but ugly, slimy-looking worms? Now, they have defoliated this whole tree.
Right above your hand. It's right on that little stem there.
You can see them right there. They're tiny, but there are big, fat ones. Oh, here he is. He's over here.
Yeah.
See it? See his slug? It's a shiny, kind of a sluggy-looking worm that appears to have no legs. At first, I thought they were ants, but then I realized that they have no legs. So I looked them up on the good old internet, only to find that they're called pear slugs. They're the larvae stage of sawflies. Sawflies bury their eggs in the ground in the fall, and then in the spring they hatch, and they come up and they attack your leaves on your plants.
Now, so how do you get rid of them?
Well, several of them, the sources I saw just said blast them with a big spray of water, because that'll knock them back down to the ground and they won't crawl back up again. I could do that. I want to take a more proactive stance. You could also use diatomaceous earth on them. For those of you that don't know what that is, it's a very minuscule little sea creature from billions of years ago that has very sharp edges, and a soft-bodied insect like this would be pierced by these sharp little edges and die of dehydration.
Kind of slices them open after as they crawl over them.
Yeah, which kind of appeals to me, but it would be a little bit slower. I tried sprinkling some on a few over here. You see that one? I'm sure he doesn't like it.
Well, I think we should cut all of these damaged leaves off, especially the ones with all of these slug worms on there. And then I think we should blast it with water.
Okay.
And then sprinkle it with diatomaceous earth.
Well, we'll see. Let's just cut them off first and spray it and see what happens.
Okay.
Just remember, you're not going to be putting these, if you have this problem, into your compost bin. That would just keep this cycle going. I'm going to cut them off, and I'm going to be putting them into a plastic bag, which is going in the garbage. Yep, there's some more.
Yep.
Now these, once they go through their cycle, will become the flies, which will eventually lay more eggs. So there will be a second infestation possibly in the fall. So we have to be careful.
Well, we have to trim this back anyhow to keep it under shape. It started as a tree, but then never really did anything.
After one winter, it just was
kind of
not good.
Disappeared, and we thought we had lost it, I think, too, right?
Right, and then it came back as a bush.
Yeah.
Which is a beautiful bush. It's a beautiful contrast to all of the green.
Now, these inner leaves are green, but the outer ones are kind of reddish bronze.
Right, that's the beauty of this.
Will these green ones turn color?
I don't think so. I think this is the new growth that's...
So it's only the new growth that keeps that color?
I think so, for the most part, until fall.
Huh.
Ew, when did I miss that? Well, I now have two helpers, Dylan and Logan, that have come to investigate and help me destroy these pear slugs. So I've got just a few more branches to pick off. And of course they saw more than I did because they got the underside view. But they're going in the garbage right here. Do you have one? Oh yeah, Dylan's got one right here. See how big they get? Ooh.
Yeah, and they eat that whole leaf away and they'll destroy this whole plant.
Okay, so now that we have them all cut off as far as we want to cut them off, you can throw that in there, Dylan, if you don't want to hold it. Now we're going to blast them, and maybe the boys would love to do the blasting part.
That'd be fun. Okay.
All right. Oh, I love it. Get them, Logan. Get in there. Really get them. Especially any leaves you see that are still half chewed off.
Kind of like going through a car wash.
A bush wash.
So now blasting them with water is going to knock them off, and
they'll
then they end up
off.
Where?
And they'll end up on the ground, but there won't be any food down there for them, so hopefully they will just shrivel up and die. Now we will have to watch again for the second coming. There will be some more that will come later on in the year, so we'll have to look again and make sure that we get those. Then I think I'm going to be putting diatomaceous earth around the base of the tree, so if anybody wants to crawl up there, they're going to have a problem.
Wasn't there a formula, though, in spring that you could use?
I'll have to look. I don't know. I don't quite remember one, but...
Okay, I thought you told me about lime.
That's right. There was a man that said you can make a paste of lime and water and paint the trunk. To prevent anything from crawling up the trunk.
In other words, any of the stems coming out, because this obviously isn't a tree, it's a bush
right now.
Yep. So you really want to get down to all of the bottom, and you're going to have to paint all of those down there. Plus, it looks like some rabbits did a little bit of girdling down way down at the bottom.
Well, that's what happens when dogs come. I lose my helper. Good job, Dylan. Thank you. Well, that's all for now. If you have a problem with pear slugs, this is how you start attacking them. If you have a better idea, please let us know. It's not the most pleasant job, but somebody's got to do it.
Well, couldn't you sprinkle diatomaceous earth on the plant right now, too?
Well, I could.
As a third?
I think I want to wait and see what happens before I take that step.
Okay.
Because I want to see some of the purple leaves before it gets all dusted with white.
True.
And it's going to rain, so.
Okay.
Please give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video.
Where's your thumb?
There are many of my thumbs. And if you have comments or questions, please send them. And we'd love to have you join our garden family and subscribe. Thank you for watching.
Connect with us on YouTube.